Number 34, Bob. Number 20, Mike Murphy.
As we mentioned at the top of this broadcast, Easton with the size, John Robb 6'7", and Ryan Smith at 6'4". Last time we saw Ryan Smith, he got into early foul problems, picked up three fouls in the first quarter, never saw action until late in the fourth quarter. So Eastern obviously has to stay out of foul problems if they're going to be successful with their big man, because if you take Smith out and Rob's going to be all alone, they're going to collapse on him.
That's a good point. I think Ryan Smith needs to have a good game. I think one of the benefits of the 16-team field, too, is teams get that early game under their belt. They feel a little bit more comfortable. He asked me the question at the top of the show, how do the two leagues compare, one in Berks County? In York County, to that have the two of them square off with pretty comparable records should be a pretty even match tonight.
John Robb going up against John. NCAA quarterfinals, District 3 underway. And the tap controlled by Eastern. Mike Rowland will put up the jumper, short. Gets his own rebound, and it goes out of bounds off of. Rowland is going right. Ball game. Mike Murphy, 5'11 junior, will bring the ball up. Murphy over to John Reedy. Reedy bounced past top of the key to Skaborik. With it now is Gene Duren. Over to Reedy. Reedy will drive the lane, dishes it off to Kowal. Over to Skaborik, back to Kowal. To Duren. To Murphy. Bounce pass to Reedy, he'll put it up. Good, off the glass.
All glass as Reading Central Catholic opens in the motion offense. Pass, screen away against Eastern's man-to-man defense until they get a good shot from their leading scorer.
Kirk Riekert, pass inside to John Robb, turnaround jumper, short. Rebound controlled by Beat Cole of Reading Central Catholic. Dishes off to Murphy. Mike Murphy, left side, bounce past to Reedy. Bounce, gets it over to Cole, who bobbled it for a second, picked it up, top of the key. Now he stops the dribble, and he walked, took a couple steps, shuffled his feet.
Reason that happened is they were running that motion offense really patterned. Pass, screen away, Eastern overplayed the passing lane, created the walk.
Minute 15 going in the first quarter, 2-0 Reading Central Catholic. Bobby Auble. Over to Rowland, now back to Auble. Auble to Rowland. Right side, inside, look for inside the Robb, but nice defense there by John Reedy to knock it away, and it's stolen by Mike Murphy. Murphy bounced past to Skaborik. Over to Reedy. Reedy almost stopped his dribble and almost got called for walking, but no call was made. Skaborik drive the lane, he'll put it up, and he's fouled by Ryan Smith. I think there was a walk on that play on Reedy's part.
I think you might be right. Just to take a look at the awkward motion that he had there. He was a little indecisive as to whether or not he was going to take the ball to the basket. The contact, I thought, came a little bit late.
They're saying the foul was before the shot. All alone on the right side, Gene Duren for two. The entire Reading Central Catholic offense went to the left side. Murphy, Duren broke to the right side. It was all alone for the easy jumper. Bobby Alba puts it up from long range. No good. John Robb there for the rebound. Puts it in. Eastern's first 2 points of the game.
Now, the first couple times down the floor, they did an excellent job of blocking out. That time, Reedy could not find him, and he was open for the offensive rebound and score.
Pete Cole. Bounce pass over to Skaborik. To Reedy. Reedy to Murphy. Left side. In and out, and he gets it. Generous rim there for Mike Murphy. It's 6-2. Kirk Riekert, he'll put it up. He's fouled. Gene Duren will pick it up. That's his first. Reading Central Catholic's first. Shearson Lehman Brothers and the Serious Investor, Minds Over Money, 110 East Market Street in York. Call 854-5553. That number once again, 854-5553. Rickard puts the first one in.
All right, take a look now. You probably don't want to foul out in this area. There's the contact on the elbow, and then more importantly, look how fundamentally he goes to block out. So at least he's thinking the game on the defensive end.
Rickard sinks both foul shots. It's 6-4. The Cardinals of Reading Central Catholic out of the Berks County League. Gene Durin. Right back that Mike Murphy. Bounces it off to Skaborek. Skaborek over to Caldwell. To Reedy.
It's interesting. They always start their offense to the left side. Always.
Skaborek from the foul line. Good.
They're shooting really hot early in this first quarter. 4 for 4.
That's hot. Smith to Auble at the foul line. He'll put it up over Murphy. Good. Mike Murphy at 5'11". Could not get his hands up that far over 5'7" Bobby Auble. That's a gutsy shot by Auble, giving away 4 inches to Murphy. 2-point lead for the Cardinals. Skaborek to Durin. Top of the key to Cole. Back over to Reedy to Murphy. Murphy bounce pass to Skaborek. To Cole at the foul line. Running Southern Catholic, perfect patient offense. That's the kind of
very patient offense. Your point is well taken, Kent. Just keep working that motion. Pass screen away until they get the shot that they want.
10-6. Ryan Smith, turnaround. A little too hard. Rob there for the rebound. Puts it up and in.
I tell you what, he's getting some offensive rebounds, but Reading Central Catholic is doing a good job of blocking him out. It's his height that's getting him, not his position.
I noticed when they have and forced Rob out of the... There's a bad shot by Reedy. Rebound Ryan Smith, but they're forcing Rob away from the basket. And they're able to get the easy shot. There's a layup by Kirk Reekerd. We're tied at 10. 3:40 left first quarter.
And Ryan Smith really made the play with the pass from midcourt.
Once again, the left side is where the Reading Central Catholic will set up the offense. Murphy over to Reedy.
The ball in. He also looks like he can shoot the medium range jump shot.
Skaborek with 6 points, leading all scorers in the game thus far. Jump shot by Rowland is no good. Rebound, Kirk Reekerd.
Nice inside position by Kirk Reekerd on the weak side. As a basketball player, you want to crash that weak side as pick off the ball as it's coming.
Reekerd in his last three games has scored 20 points in those three games. Durin. Defraney. Top of the foul line shot there by Mike Murphy. Reading Central Catholic shooting the daylights out of the ball so far.
9 of 10, 90%, not bad. Of course,
there's a jump shot, tagged good by Bobby Auble.
I just like that head motion at the end. Bobby Auble just kind of went, hey, I'll take him any way I can get him.
16-14. Biggest lead of the game so far has been 4 points by Reading Central Catholic. Franey. Left side to Murphy, inside, Smith up in the air. Shot was blocked out of bounds.
By the speed with which Mike Murphy whipped that ball in from the wing to the low post, Eastern's got to really play tough on the inside possession.
Murphy with 1:25 left. Over to Franey, to Durin, to Reedy. Reedy thought about taking the shot, then decided to pass it out.
Ken, watch how many bounce passes they use around the perimeter. That's very unusual. Mostly teams will whip the ball around the perimeter. They bounce pass it.
Murphy coming up on the 1 minute mark left in the first quarter. Murphy cross court to Durin.
Part of the reason for that was because of the 2-3 zone that Eastern's put on, even though they're pressuring out front a little bit. But against the man-to-man, they were using a lot of bounce passes.
Eastern's now been told they must come out and play. They've been warned to come out and play. Down by two. Eastern doesn't come out and play. They could be called for a technical foul. Franey tries to drive inside, has nothing, bounces it out to Skaborek, out to Durin. 30 seconds left. Franey, top of the key to Reedy, to Skaborek.
You see, Eastern went back, pass, and screen away. That's, you just keep doing it until you break a man open or get a backdoor situation.
10 seconds left. Franey and Reedy nearly lost the basketball. 6 seconds, 14 after one over Eastern. We'll be back.
Passes the ball.
Reedy gets inside the lane. And there's a foul. It will be on Mike Rowland.
There's a little bit of a break because I think that foul could have been called on Rob coming in from that backside again, going for the block.
That's the first on Rowland.
See, a difference so far in this game, Reading Central Catholic has 5 guys in the scoring column. Eastern has only Auble, Rob, and Reekerd. Now watch his foul call here. Watch Rob go in from the backside. The foul is going to be called on Mike Rowland.
But Robb tries to block it from behind.
And Reedy makes both. It's 22-16. Minute gone by here in the second quarter. Bobby Auble works the right side. Jump shot by Kirk Reichard. Sinks it. We could have a high-scoring game here, Craig.
Well, that would be according to Eastern's plan, the way they played over the course of the season, especially the latter part since the York Catholic game.
Eastern has averaged 78 points a game in the YCI.
That's how I was able to convince my dad.
Which is 13th. And for a team to finish second in the Eastern Division, that's not a good defensive team.
No, but they were number one in offense, so.
Gene Durrett sinks the jumper. And Reading Central Catholic continues to shoot well from the field. There's a pass inside to Smith from Auble, lays it up and in. That pass play was originally intended for John Robb.
So, went down.
Let Mixie have and turn it into two.
Torres. To Franey. Franey working it to the middle. Bounce pass to Torres.
If you're a student of the game, just watch how they... Oh, now I do not believe that was a walk. I really felt his left foot stayed stationary, but it looked awkward. And when it looks awkward, the official sometimes will blow it.
A little on edge lately. It's just this whole thing has been... I understand how difficult it is to work yourself into somebody's confidence. I do appreciate the fact that you put yourself on the line for me as well. Thank you. We're going to find out what happened to Rick. Would you mind driving? No, why? Because I want to fix these nails. Searching Hunter's house took a bad hit. Haven't been any reports from any local hospitals or doctors as of yet, but if that guy was hurt bad enough to need help, he might want to try and find a doctor who would forget he pulled a bullet out of someone, you know what I mean? You think they still haven't found what they were after? Well, that place was pretty messed up when I got there, and they hadn't left, so I definitely interrupted their search. I don't know how you can tell. This isn't exactly Mr. Immaculate. You know Hunter? Huh? Oh, yeah, sure. A few years ago when he was on loan to our division with that string of prostitute murders, we got together and compared notes. And this led to that, that led to this. Hey, you know, this is a great color, isn't it? Yeah, it's very nice.
Something wrong?
Yeah. I got the feeling we were being followed.
A black Ferrari?
Yeah.
I thought so too, but he pulled off about three blocks back.
Cardinals are pulling it out. Darren Torres, cross court. Torres looking for some help, gets it over to Franey. Reading Central Catholic just waiting for the good shot. There it is, Reedy, yes!
Their passing game is very sound. It's what makes them as a team. Petey Carrill, the old Reading High School coach that's now at Princeton for many years, many, many passes till you get the shot that you want.
They're calling a foul on John Robb. They're gonna say it was over the back, or he pushed off.
All right, you make the call. Again, keep in mind that games sometimes are called a little bit differently in districts. Oftentimes you get away with a little more physical play. But yes, he did ride his back a little bit. It was his stretch there.
But they're calling a push-off, and I don't know if he pushed off.
You know, I don't think you would have saw that called the other night in Quad A. That's just my opinion.
3:30 left, first half. Darren being guarded by Reichard. Now it's Murphy with the ball back in the game.
Franey to Reedy to Murphy at the foul line. Too hard, but Franey there for the rebound. Works away inside, puts up the layup. No good, but the foul's going to be Ryan Smith. That's two. Yeah. 28-24, 3:10 left. Kevin Franey at the line for two. First shot is good. Take a look at the replay.
All right, again, the Reading Central Catholic kids are not afraid to take it to the basket. That time, an excellent pump fake to the left, goes back to the right, and draws the foul. Kevin Franey.
Donnie Knobb in the game for Mike Rowland. Smith nearly going inside too soon, but it wouldn't have mattered anyway, as Franey makes two. Auble and Rieker almost had a miscommunication there. Who's going to get the ball from the inbounds pass, but Auble got it. Pass stolen there by Gene Derren. Looking inside for Rob. That's the fourth turnover. 30-24. Reading Central Catholic up by six. 2:45 to go. Auble almost had a steal. Rob gets it. John Rob behind the back pass. Bobby Auble pick it up. Puts it off the glass. Good.
Great play. Defensively, Bobby Auble forces the pressure. Rob doesn't hesitate to come up, and then the pass to Auble to make it. Auble gets two in the book. Rob, two in Coach Eckert's heart.
Eastern pressing now. And there's another steal by Bobby Auble, but he loses it to Zubark, who lay it up. No good. We have a foul. It's going to be against John Rob. That'll be two.
And John Rob leaves his about size 12 or 13 footprints, right footprint, right in the middle of the chest of Bob Skaborik.
Calling a one-on-one situation here with 2:19 left.
I think he ought to get two shots just for taking the foot in the chest. Certainly it was unintentional by John Robb.
Robb gets the rebound of the missed foul shot. Knobb to Auble. Back to Knobb. He'll put it up. Short. Rebound. Ryan Smith there. Blocked by Derren. Gets his own rebound. Puts it up. Good. We got a foul. To 28, 2:03 left. What a ball game thus far, Craig.
It is indeed, and I would think now that Reading Central Catholic would have to be a little careful in this last 2 minutes, because they had a 6-point lead that now has diminished to two, with Smith on the line with a chance to cut it to one. And the last 2 minutes of a half can be very critical as far as your mental attitude going into the halftime.
Smith misses the foul shot. He tried to dish it off to Donnie Knobb. And Knobb wanted to go up with the ball, but he didn't have it yet. Took his eyes off of it, goes out of bounds. Pete Lawton in the game for Ryan Smith. Smith leaving the game with 4 points.
Eastern has really turned up the defensive pressure here, which has made a difference in the last minute and a half.
Gene Derren nearly stepped out of bounds on the near side. No call made. Some of the Eastern fans sitting there, almost the back court.
This is incredible. As good a passing team as Reading Central Catholic is in the half court, they're not a good passing team against this pressure.
Reading Central Catholic will pull it out with 1:35 left. Franey to Murphy. Murphy top of the key, looking for some help. Bounces it over to Franey. Franey works his way to Skaborik. Over to Murphy. Bounce pass intended for Reedy, but Reedy didn't go to it. Eastern with a chance to tie it up. Timeout Eastern. No good by Kirk Rieker. There's a foul on Reading Central Catholic.
Now, Mike Murphy would not have gotten that foul if he would have been facing the basket, but instead he turned his back and tried to go in hard after the rebound. Got called for the foul, a correct call by the official.
Donnie Knobb at the line, shooting 1-1. Exactly 1 minute left here in the first half.
I like the timeout call by Mark Eckert. Even with 1:17 to go, he wants this lead going into the half.
But the Knights are having some problems at the foul line. 2 of 5, and they missed their last three. Murphy. Derren back to Murphy, left side. Derren with it to Murphy. 45 seconds left. Cardinals will pull it out, looking for the good shot. Murphy. Now comes out on him. Gets it to Skaborek. Gets it to Reedy. Reedy will drive the baseline. Has nothing. Bounces back out to Murphy. 30 seconds left. Reedy. To Murphy. Back over to Duren. At the center court. Now moves it over to the right side. Duren with it to Murphy. 15 seconds left. Now he'll go back. 10 seconds left. Murphy bounces it over to Reedy. Reedy will drive, loses it to Bobby Obo. 5 seconds left. Obo on the break. Nice behind the back pass to Robson. We're tied at 30. Oh, my. Unbelievable dunk by John Robb with 1 second to go. That ties it up at 30. We'll be back and analyze this exciting first half in just a moment.
Some people see the sunset as the end of the day. Others see it as the beginning of an evening.
John Robb, Craig, has this gym rocking. What a way to end the first half.
Two plays have turned this game around. One was Auble's pressure defense, Robb recovery, Auble layup. The next one was this play right here. But really, the thing that makes this play is that pass right there. Look at that. Letter high, man. Right there on the money. Robb couldn't fumble it. He didn't have to go after it. It was in perfect position to slam dunk it. What a mind game that does on the Cardinals going into halftime. I thought what was neat was the waiting team, Susquehanna Township kids over in that corner area, just went crazy on that play.
Unbelievable. That should give Eastern a lot of momentum entering the second half. Let's take a look at the team stats first of all.
Interesting first half. One of the best games we've had. 30 all here. And when you take a look at the numbers, they're a little deceptive because, first of all, field goals, Eastern, 14 of 26, 54%. The Cardinals, with that very patient passing game in the half court, got off 17 shots in the first half, made 13, 76%. At the free throw line, Eastern was there 5 times, hit 2, missing their last 3. The Cardinals also there 5 times, hitting 4. Turnovers, even at 5. Nothing significant except the 2 that were converted into scores. The Auble layup, the Robb slam dunk to end the first half. Eastern scored 10 points on 10 offensive rebounds. And when you take a look at the rebounds, that might be at this point the key stat in the game. As expected, Eastern out-rebounding Reading Central Catholic 2-1.
On the individual side, Craig, Bobby Auble leading the Knights with 10 points. John Robb and Kirk Weaker with 8. But Robb's last 2 points, the big ones on that slam dunk. For the Cardinals of Reading Central Catholic, Gene Duren leading with 10, Bob Skaborek with 6, and John Reedy also with 6 for the Cardinals. We are tied 30-30 here at Central York High School Class AA quarterfinals between Eastern and Reading Central Catholic. Don't go away, my friends. We have an exciting second half for you, so stay tuned. Hi, Mom.
Here in spring training is where we put it all together for the coming season. You got to start early, whether it's baseball or filing your taxes. File now and you'll be less likely to overlook deductions or make last-minute mistakes. And if you got a refund coming, you're going to get it faster. So why don't you put it all together? File now, and come April, while I'm hard at work, you can just sit back and enjoy the game.
Second half of the District 3 Class AA quarterfinals between Reading Central Catholic and Eastern, tied at 30. Ken Shalom with Craig Smith and statistician Paul Goodemont. And Craig, John Robb gave us another highlight again this year. Last year he gave us that block at the York Catholic game. Now the dunk.
He's putting together his own little highlight videotape. And the halftime break simply gave these fans a chance to catch their breath, because if the second half comes close to what we've seen in the first half, we have definitely picked the right game in this quarterfinal round.
Bobby Auble with the ball for Eastern as they start with the ball. Rolling for 2. He gives Eastern the lead for the first time in this ball game, 32-30. How much will that dunk give Eastern momentum? Does it give them a lot?
Yes, because they tied the game for the first time since 10 going into the locker room. And I think the pressure defense of Eastern late in the second quarter, coupled with their two turnovers they created resulting in scores, was very instrumental in the mental aspect of their game and has to make Reading Central Catholic think twice.
Murphy to Skaborek, or Cole, excuse me. Inside to Skaborek for two. We're tied.
Boy, that was a nice pass inside by Reedy. He really split the zone defense.
Minute gone by here in the first quarter. Rob over to Riekert. Goes out of bounds off of Reading Central Catholic. It'll be Eastern basketball.
The RCC coaches went crazy on that one. I thought Rob walked as well. It was a very, very awkward move.
Rowland in the corner. Out to Smith. Back to Rowland. They didn't have the jumper, so we got it out to Auble. Back to Rowland. Auble. Looking inside for Rob. They have him. Rob, turn around. No good.
That was not a great entry. It was a good pass, but it wasn't the right pass because he was surrounded by four white shirts. They should have reversed the ball and worked it inside from the weak side.
Cole out to Murphy. Murphy with it. Top of the key. Out to Cole. Back out to Murphy. Cross court right side to Duren in the corner. Gets it back out. Inside to Skaborek, over to Reedy, over Rob, short. Rebound, we have foul on the play. It's going to go against Eastern, I believe. Kirk Riekert will pick up the foul. Take a look at that play once again as we take a look at Coach Dan Hawney of Reading Central Catholic. Well, we will take a look at it then. 6:10 left here in the third quarter. Murphy to Reedy. Cole back to Murphy. Over to Cole. Top of the key. They're just playing, being patient with it. Playing catch. Cole to Reedy. Interesting now. Rob inside as Riekert guarding Reedy on the outside.
Well, they don't want to pull Rob away from the basket. This is interesting. I still say Reading Central Catholic wants to play against a man-to-man. They're very patient against both. The thing they did not react well to in the first half was pressure. Be interesting to see when Mark Eckert goes back to that.
Pete Cole gives Reading Central Catholic the lead, 34-32. Ryan Smith is fouled by John Reedy.
I think they got away with one there. That was a long skip pass because it went from corner to corner. They really caught Reading in a shift to the strong side of the floor. And I think really they were kind of fortunate that the weak side defense of Reading Central Catholic was not that alert.
Smith at the line for the Golden Knights, who are the fourth seeded team in his Class AA tournament. And Smith takes the first.
Watch what I mean here. See how far out the ball is. It's out beyond the timeline. Weak side pass there. There was an attempt after, but the weak side was pulled across the floor too much. Watch for some pressure if he makes his foul shot.
He doesn't make it as Skaborek comes down with the rebound. Mike Murphy with the ball. Takes his time bringing it up. Bounces it over to Cole. Left side, Cole over to Reedy. Back out to Cole. Cole gets it over to Murphy. To Skaborek. Skaborek to Reedy. Reedy all alone. Bob blocks it. John Rod with the block. But Easter throws it right back to Gene Duren of Reading Central Catholic.
It wasn't blocked, it was spiked. You know, he brought it right back in Reedy's face. Unfortunately, they couldn't even get a shot off.
Skaborek loses the ball as he tried to go up for the layup, and Smith takes it. Hobble with it now for the Knights.
Let's watch and see how that affects Reedy the next time he has a chance at a shot.
Rob, nice give and go passing. That goes out of bounds, and Rob missed the shot off of Reading Central Catholic, but good pinpoint passing by Eastern.
It was good pass to the inside. The one thing I'd like to see John Rob work on, maybe over the summer, is a real strong power move to the glass. He tends to be a little bit too much of a finesse player sometimes. He's got to realize he's got the body to do it. Just take it and power it up to that glass in the square.
Spork knocks the ball out of Rob's hands. Eastern will try it again. 4:39 left, 34-33. Rowland to Rob. Outside to Rowland. Rowland will put it up. No good. Rebound. Control by no one. It goes off of Kirk Riekert on the line. It's Reading Central Catholic basketball. Second half moving kind of slowly so far.
That's just an optical illusion after the finish to the first half.
Cool. Over to Kevin Franey. Skaborek to Gene Darren. Darren will work his way inside. A little move there. Looking, he was looking for a foul. Nothing called. Rob gets the rebound. Bobby Aubel. Inside the Rob. Rob's there. Put it up. Good.
Now that time, it took a finesse move because he had to put the ball on the floor. The defense collapsed. The finesse move got him the good shot.
Houston with the one-point lead. 3:45 left, third quarter. Mike Murphy with the ball. Murphy, right side, bounce pass to Darren. All alone under the basket was Franey, but Eastern steals. Bobby Alba once again, the spark plug of this night ball club. 5'7" senior. Rakerd, short, rebound, Skaborek. Skaborek dumps it off to Murphy. Murphy working the left side. Walks his way over to the center, dumps it off to Cole. Cole to Franey in the corner. Franey back out to Cole. Cole out top to Murphy. Back over to Cole to Franey. Franey stops. His path to the baseline blocked by Rob. Now he'll put it up. In and out. Rebound Skaborek. He'll put it up over Smith. Good. And Dan Hawney, the Reading Central coach, likes that. 36-35 as the Cardinals take the one-point lead back from Eastern. Aubel inside the Rob. Rob, turn around. Call it.
He does an excellent job of keeping the ball up in the air. If he brings it down, guards are going to go after it and strip him of it. He keeps it up. Good play by John Rob.
Seesaw battle, 37-36. The Knights over the Cardinals. Cole. Skaborek to Darren. Darren, right side, gets it back out to Cole. Over to Murphy. Murphy will put it up. No good. Too hard off the glass. Rebound Eastern on the break. Here goes Rowland. Rowland over Murphy. Good. Eastern with its biggest lead.
Good body control by Rowland. That'll be a timeout for the Cards.
2:05 left, third quarter. The Knights lead 39-36. We'll be back.
This is Dr. Robert Davis, president of the York Hospital Medical Staff, urging you to take time to donate a unit of blood. Donating a unit of
Ken Charlo with Craig Smith and statistician Paul Goodemote. Eastern up by 3, 39-36 in the quarterfinals of the District 3 Class AA basketball playoffs.
It was a good timeout call by Dan Hawney because his team went down 3. Now that's the biggest lead that Eastern has had in this game. And with 2:05 to go in the third quarter, he doesn't want it to get out of control because if Eastern can go up 5, then 7 and build on that with the big man Rob and the ability to hold the ball, it'll make a difference. Eastern is 4 of 8, 50% so far in the third quarter. RCC, 3 of 8, 38%. So they've cooled down considerably from that 9 of 10 shooting that they've opened the game with.
Cardinals will continue to be patient. Franey has the open baseline over Rob. And Rob intimidated him. And Rob draws the foul. That's 4 on Reedy.
Now keep in mind, he's their leading scorer. He averages 11 on the year. Tonight, he's got only 6 in the book. He has yet to score in the second half.
Aubel. To roll. He'll put it up. It's no good. There's a foul underneath the basket. It's going to go against Eastern's Kirk Rakerd. For Rakerd, that's number 2. Of course, our foul totals are unofficial. We have Reedy for 4. And now there's some complaining along the Reading Central Catholic bench.
I suspect that they just realized the situation that Reedy's in. You have him for 4, right, Paul? Okay, 4 fouls. They got to get him out of the game.
Murphy. Over to Darren. To Franey. Franey has the baseline. Thought twice when he saw Rob over there. There's a walk. Gene Darren knew it. Pete Cole checking back into the game for the Cardinals.
Remember, this game is being brought to you here on Cable 4 York by Shearson Lehman Brothers and the Serious Investor. Minds over money at 110 East Market Street. Call 854-5553.
The Cardinals get John Greedy out of the ball game. Bad pass there by Kirk Reichert, stolen by Murphy. Murphy will bring it up. Over to Cole. Back out to Murphy. Murphy, double team, gets it over to Duren. Back out to Murphy. To Cole. To Murphy. They're just taking their time. Less than a minute to go. Third quarter. Franey will drive to the baseline. Rob right there. Gets it over. Rob, no good. John Rob, the intimidator for the Eastern Golden Knights. 45 seconds left. Alba with the ball.
They'll take the high percentage shot, but I think they'd like to work it down and get up five at the end of the quarter.
Alba gets the ball off a deflection. No good. Rob battles in for the rebound. Puts it up. No good. He taps it up again. No good. Gets another rebound. No good, but he's fouled. Foul's going to go against Mike Murphy. That's his third.
And I think the key thing now is to take a look and see if Eastern can improve on their foul shooting. They are 3 of 7 for the night. They have made only one of their last 5 shots. And so John Robb, as a leader on this team, can make a significant contribution from the foul line right now.
He sinks the first.
The key here, Auble picks up the loose ball. Maybe shouldn't have taken the shot, but he knows he's got Rob to the inside. Rob keeps the ball up in the air. He gets hit once. It's back off. He gets hit again, and he goes to the line.
And he sinks both foul shots. It's 41-36, the Knights of Eastern.
Let's see how the Cards react to this pressure this time.
All alone underneath the basket is Franey. And he gets the foul. Kevin Franey draws the third foul on John Rob.
John Robb got caught out of position. He was the foul shooter. It was his responsibility to turn around and sprint right down the court and be the protector of the basket. He didn't do that. Not that he loafed, but he came up short, and they passed behind the defense and forced the foul.
Brady in a near kneel position, sinks the first. Pete Lawton will come in to replace John Robb. Lawton, a 6-0 senior, averaging 4.5 points a game during this regular season. Franey will get another foul shot. 41-37, 24 seconds left, third quarter. Franey sinks both. 3-point Knights lead. Mike Rowland with it over to Bobby Auble. 15 seconds left. Smith back to Auble. Easton will take the final shot. Auble to Reichert. Back. Now Reichert will keep it with 5 seconds left to Auble. Auble put it up. No good. Rebound, Ryan Smith. His shot is short. And that'll end the third quarter. And the Knights take a 41-38 lead here after three quarters. And Craig, really a slow-moving quarter for both teams. The Eastern is starting to slowly get that momentum.
It really was a slow quarter. And again, I said at first that was in comparison to the way we finished in a flourish at the end of the second quarter to go into the locker room. But I think what tends to happen here, Ken, we're in the second round. We're in playoff competition. The team that wins here goes to the semifinals. If they do that, they're also guaranteed of states. And so teams tend to get a little cautious.
3-point lead for the Golden Knights. Let's go downstairs on the Eastern bench with Mark Eckert.
On the ball, keeping track of each other. Somebody penetrates the other and comes back to the point. You roll low and Mike goes through. Opposite back man comes up.
Defense, the key word here for the Eastern Golden Knights. They have to protect that 3-point lead.
Well, your feelings were pretty much correct as far as the feeling of the quarter. It bears it out in numbers. Eastern, 4 of 13, 31% from the field in the third quarter. RCC, 3 of 10, 30%. 3 of 4 at the line for Eastern, 2 of 2 for Reading Central Catholic. Eastern maintains their rebounding edge, 10 to 5 or 2 to 1 ratio.
Torres in the game now for Reading Central Catholic. He has the ball. Marino Torres over to Cole. Cole put it up. Gets the roll.
Must be something magical about that basket at that end tonight. Auble got some rolls there. Now Reading Central Catholic does as well.
Central Catholic putting on some pressure. Now they drop out of it. Auble. Over to Rowland. Each team will be pretty cautious about their shot selection now. Season for both teams riding on this fourth quarter. Auble drives late, forced it up, no good. Ball batted out of bounds off of Ryan Smith. Golden Knights will lose possession. Bobby Auble trying to force something that probably wasn't there. And Reading Central Catholic with a chance to take the lead once again. Torres with the ball, top of the key. Bounces it over to Skoborek. Skoborek to Cole. To Darren, he'll put it up. No good, rebound Pete Lawton. John Robb on the bench with three for Eastern, three fouls. Bobby Auble, cross court to Rieker. Rieker to put it up. Gets the roll off the rim and the glass.
And that's an even more important shot than what you might think, because that allows Coach Eckert to keep Rob on the bench for another minute.
Coming right back, Skoborek over Smith. Layup no good. Rebound, Rieker. We're going the other way. Rieker will slow it down. Johnny Knob getting set to check in for the Golden Knights. Rieker inside to Ryan Smith. Ryan lays it up and in. Count it. And he'll go to the line.
Big play in the game to put the Knights up five with 6:19 to go. Ryan Smith, kind of a finesse shot.
6:19 left. Eastern will take a timeout. We'll take one as well. 45-40, the Knights up with Ryan Smith attempting the three-point play. We'll be back.
The pessimist sees the glass as half empty.
Play for Ryan Smith, Craig.
All right, nice entry pass in from the corner. That's a little bit tough with the angle there, and you see the contact is made inside. Ryan Smith actually adjusted his shot to avoid the contact.
Bob Skoborek picks up his second foul for the Cardinals. At this point, with Eastern with a five-point lead, why would Eckert take a timeout?
Well, I think there's a couple things in his mind. He's taken one at an unusual time, 1:17 to go in the first half. He takes it now as he goes up five, knowing that after the timeout he could go up six. It allows him to rethink briefly the Rob situation, and it allows him to get his strategy organized as to whether or not he wants to hold the ball and take time off the clock or be aggressive on offense with a team that's averaging 86 points a game.
Smith completes the three-point play. John Robb is right now sitting next to Mark Eckert. He might be checking back into the game momentarily. Six-point lead for the Knights. Cole to Torres to Franey. Remember, John Reedy on the bench for Reading Central Catholic with four fouls. And Catholic turns the ball over. And John Robb checks back in for Eastern.
See, that's a real luxury. He was able to take about a minute and a half off the clock and build his lead with Robb on the bench.
And Pete Lawton checks out, and Lawton did a pretty good job for
his
time.
He did an excellent job. You remember he pulled down a key defensive rebound, and those kind of contributions sometimes go unnoticed by the fans in favor of the big-name players or the big scorers.
Auble to Donnie Knob. Less than 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Auble spins around. Torres will put up the jumper. Short. Rob there for the rebound. Off the glass. Good.
Mark Eckert, you asked why did he take a timeout. He has made some excellent strategy moves in this game to build to an eight-point lead.
Knights pressing. Knights with the biggest lead of the game, 8 points. Reading Central Catholic breaks the press. Three on one for Franey, no good. But right there for the rebound, Skoborek, he puts it in.
I think he's had an excellent game.
John Robb could have picked up his fourth foul there, too. It's close.
Very close. I think they have to get Reedy back into the ball game and have him fire up a couple shots and regain his confidence. You cannot have your leading scorer on the bench going down the stretch.
Rieker to Knob. Looking inside, doesn't have anything. Now gets it to Rob at the foul line. Rob to Rieker. Rieker turn around over Darren. Good! Unbelievable shot!
You know, it was an unbelievable shot because I don't really think when he got the ball and turned that Rieker really wanted to take the shot. He sort of double clutched, and when he felt the contact, little as it was, he put the ball up and put it down for two. Now watch how they reverse the ball, and you're gonna see it come back. Kirk Rieker will be on the right wing coming off a screen. Now watch that, nice move. He loses his defensive man, turn ball on the floor, turns and face, contact, shot.
Rieker missed the foul shot. Robb got the rebound, but he walked with the basketball. 5 minutes left. 8-point lead for the Knights. Torres, 3D back in the ballgame.
Torres looking for Reed, doesn't have anything, gets it to Duren, right side. Duren to Torres, fake the shot. Skoborek back out to Duren, over to Reedy. Now Torres will put it up from long range, good. 50-44, 4.5 minutes left in regulation time. Bobby Aubel for the Knights. Aubel drives the lane, nice behind the back pass to Smith. Smith was not expecting it. Turnover for the Knights.
Now you might say that was a good pass, it was on the money, but if a player's not expecting it, the timing is wrong.
Torres, 6-point Knight lead. Franey gets it to Skoborek, back out to Duren. Gene Duren, cross court to Torres, back out to Duren. Over to Franey, inside to Skoborek, he'll drive, Rob blocks it. Rieker picks up the rebound. And Aubel bring the ball up for the Eastern Knights. Donnie Knob, inside to John Robb, turn around, count it.
They've got to keep going to the glass, to the inside, because I don't think the foul line is going to carry them tonight. So that was an excellent move, continuing to pound the ball inside to Robb.
3.5 minutes left. Torres loses the ball, Aubel steals. Break. Aubel, pump fake, good. 10-point lead for the Knights with 3:20 left.
Would you say that Bobby Aubel has made a difference in this game tonight?
I think he has. He's been the spark plug, as I said. He's just 5'7". He's been just a little pest out there. 54-44. We'll be back.
Someone is smoking over there.
Something we cats would never do.
Filling their lungs with thick, dark air.
What a disgusting thing to do.
Cats have 9 lives with 8 to spare. Humans have 1.
With none to barter.
Why do they smoke?
Why don't they care?
Humans are smart, but cats are smarter. Listen to cats, you men and women. Take care of your lungs. They're only human.
The American Lung Association, the Christmas Seal people.
This baby's mother took drugs. The baby was born hooked. It's a tough way to start life. Hard drugs and pregnancy don't mix. A warning from the March of Dimes.
Bobby Aubel with 12 points in the game, and this key one right here.
He's done it once, he's done it twice, and now he's done it thrice tonight. On the steals, Bobby Aubel. Excellent game by the hustle guard.
Torres with the jumper, it's no good. Ryan Smith with the rebound. Eastern Golden Knights looking to reserve their ticket to Hershey Park Arena for the Class AA Finals State Championship. The Knights should win this game, they're on their way. They'll clinch at least a berth in the playoff, in the state playoff. Gene Duren called for a foul. That's number 3.
Now, this is the point in the game. You look at the clock, you say there's 3 minutes to go, we're up 10. Coaches coach for this kind of situation. In practice, you play mind games with your kids. You're up 10 in a playoff game, you're at the foul line. Let's see if you can drop it with a little bit of pressure on. Foul shooting wins games in the last 3 minutes.
Rakert sinks the first one, 55-44. He'll get another, he puts it in. 56-44. Less than 3 minutes to go. Jump shot by Duren is no good. Ryan Smith there for the rebound. And a foul goes against Skoborek. That's number 3.
If you're enjoying this action on Cable 4 York at playoff time, you have the folks at Shearson Lehman Brothers to thank. The Shearson Lehman Brothers and the serious investor, Minds Over Money. In York at 110 East Market Street, call 854-5553. Minds Over Money.
Mechanicsburg High School will be the site of the AA semifinals and final for District 3. Coming up March 3rd, semifinals, and March 6th, the final. And of course, those sites are tentative. They're subject to change. Right now, Eastern doesn't care where it's playing. They'll be in the state finals, should they win state playoffs if they win this ball game.
And they'll be in the district semifinals And we really have an opportunity going into tonight's game to see two AAA teams in the semifinals. York Catholic still has a shot, as does West York. I think Eastern has a really good shot to be in the finals in District 3 AA.
Darren, with Torres, he'll put it up. Good. 57-46, 230 to go, excuse me.
Now they need to protect the ball, pass well, and shoot well at the foul line.
Bobby Alba breaks the pressure. Inside the Ryan Smith for the easy two.
Win, lose, or draw, Bobby Alba is our player of the game tonight. He is hitting people with passes right where they should be hit.
Reedy tried to drive inside, but he draws the foul instead.
You know, we talk about what's significant in a playoff game in a pressure situation. Yes, it's how well you shoot. Yes, it's how well you do at the foul line. Yes, it can be turnovers, but I still think in a playoff situation, rebounding is the key. Eastern has out-rebounded RCC 29-13 tonight.
Timeout on the court, 2:11 to go. Reading Central Catholic takes the timeout. 59-46, Eastern up by 13. We'll be back.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bob Rainier, your host for Cable 4 Bingo, coming your way every month.
Our ball game, Ken Shiloh with Craig Smith and statistician Paul Goodabout. The quarterfinals of the District 3 AA Boys Basketball Playoffs.
And the winner of this game goes on to play the winner of the Reading Holy Name Littlestown game, which is being played as we speak at Reading High School. And that will be the semifinal round in District 3.
Reedy misses both foul shots. Rob gets the rebound, but has the ball knocked out of his hands by Marino Torres. Eastern will pick up possession. Cardinals will press. The Knights break it. Coming up on 2 minutes left in the ballgame. All ball being held up, double team now. Ball kicked up, nearly into our booth. We tried.
Never can tell, Ken, what'll come your way, whether it's a hockey puck or a basketball.
Rob with it, off to Auble. He's fouled by Torres. 1-1.
So I got a feeling we're in for a long minute and 55 seconds because it's foul time.
The longest minute and 55 seconds of your life, ladies and gentlemen.
When you're standing at the foul line, it is too.
Auble at the line for the 1-1. 1:55 left, 13-point lead for the Golden Knights. This time the roll's not there for Auble. Auble knocks the ball out of bounds on an attempted pass by Pete Cowell.
That's not hurting them at this point, but they're 9 of 16 at the night on the foul line, and in a close game, you've got to be able to make that shot.
Reedy, double team, gets it over to Murphy. He'll put it up. No good. Ryan Smith there for the rebound. He's going to be called for the foul. Ryan Smith called for the foul. But they're calling on Donnie Knob now.
Yeah, that was a real unusual call. Knob was away from a lot of the contact on that play, and I really thought that the foul was going to go against Reading Central Catholic.
Instead, John Reedy will be taking foul shots. Makes the first.
And that's his first points of the second half. I think that's certainly significant when your number one scorer did not score until 1:41 to go in the ballgame in the second half.
Second shot is short. Rob for the rebound. Rob needs some help. Gets it out to Auble. And there's a foul. Torres picks up a foul as he's caught the arm of Kirk Reichert. Reichert with 14 points will go to the line. 1:34 left. By the way, Bobby Auble's playing on a bad left foot. He had a brace on his foot. Basically all season, Coach Ecker was telling me before the start of the game. Eastern wants a timeout. And they'll get it. We'll keep it right here. Auble had the brace break off, and some of the metal was cutting into his foot.
Well, he strikes me as a real gutty kind of kid, just real hard worker. And that, you know, a minor type injury like that certainly may have some effect. But once the ball goes up that opening tip, the adrenaline starts pumping. And a kid like Bobby Auble is going to give you 100% plus, which he has done tonight. Eastern's an interesting team, playing head-to-head with, like, York Catholic, York High, some of the bigger teams in the York County League, when they go into the double-A playoffs, when you go into any of the playoffs in District 3 with a good inside player at 6'7", as John Robb is, a quick guard like Bobby Alble can handle the ball, and then the nice complementary players like the Ryan Smiths, like the Mike Rollins, like the Pete Lawtons that can come off the bench, you have yourself a nice team at any level, and when you're playing head-to-head with double-A competition, you really have something going.
Minute 34 to go. Another unusual timeout there by Coach Eckert.
He's taking, I like his timeout calls, though, because I feel like he's taking them because he's in control, not because he's in a panic. And I tell you, you always want to be taking those timeouts with up 14.
61-47. Torres will put it up from long range. Nothing but air. Smith the rebound to Knob. Knob, alley-oop, almost, but Rieckert there for the rebound. No good. Going the other way, Torres will lay it up, no good. Donnie Knob for the rebound, he gets it out to Aubel, 1:10 to go. Aubel has the ball stripped, 4-on-1 for Mr. Reedy. Reedy with the basket. Coming up with 1 minute to go, 61-49. And there's a foul, two-shot foul for Eastern. Gonna go against Murphy, I believe.
It's a correct call, because he made the deliberate foul to stop the scoring attempt. You know, both these teams are interesting, Ken, in that Eastern will return three starters, Robb, Rieckert, and Smith, plus Donnie Knob, that's played a lot this year. Reading Central Catholic will return Reedy, Skaborik, Murphy, and Kowal, four starters, plus Franey, the sixth man. So both these teams you would expect to be back in the thick of things in 1988 when it comes to playoff time.
John Robb and Bobby Alble taken out of the ball game, replaced by Pete Lawton.
That's some confidence, isn't it, Ken? What do you think? Up 12 with 58 seconds to go?
Lawton and Roland in the game. The two-shot deliberate foul, and Easton will get the ball back, too. Rieckert at the line. Makes the first.
Well, if you're wondering, once again, these two teams, the winners of these two teams, will go on to meet the winner of Reading Holy Name and Littlestown. We plan to have our Cable 4 York cameras at Elizabethtown College, which is scheduled as the site, for a March 3rd game between York Catholic, or the winner, I should say, of the York Catholic Greencastle Antrim game, and the winner of the Lancaster Catholic West York game. Wouldn't it be something if the Bulldogs pull another upset and we have a York County semifinal? It has happened before, and between the Irish and the Bulldogs.
It also happened at District 3 final a couple years ago when Catholic and Suburban met up at Hershey Park Arena.
It was a good one.
Foul on the play. Goes against Reedy. He's out of the ball game. Donnie Knob puts the first one in. Tim Iswald in, replacing Reedy.
I like this. I like the fact that Coach Eckert is getting some of his part-time players into the ball game, getting them some playoff chances.
63-49. Murphy puts up a bank shot. No good. Rebound. Knob, he loses it. Darren puts it in. 63-51. 40 seconds remaining. Knob, double teamed. He's fouled.
I'm impressed by the way Eastern is not fouling. You know, if the ball gets stolen, they give them the layup and say, look, go ahead, you're going to get two, but you're not going to get three.
Ed Reisinger coming into the game. Kirk Rieckert going out of the ball game. Rieckert leaves the game with 17 points. And as we said at the top of the broadcast, earlier in the broadcast, Kirk Rieckert has averaged 20 points in his last three games, 22, 27, and 11. Rieckert averaged 10 points during the regular season. Knob puts the first one in. Steve Klein coming in. Brad Henneis coming in. Lawton goes out of the game. Smith goes out of the game. 39 seconds remaining. The Eastern Golden Knights have a ticket for the state playoffs. Golden Knights road to Hershey Park will continue no matter what they do now the rest of districts.
Both teams making wholesale changes now. Pete Conwell coming out of the game along with Mike Murphy, Fred Carr in, and Chris Horrigan in. Duren over to Torres. He'll put it up. Banks it, no good. Rebound, Reisinger. He's fouled by Torres. 65-51. I think a key here for Eastern is they've averaged 6-7 points given up defensively during the season. They have kept Reading Central Catholic to under that average with 51 points. And considering the way Reading Central Catholic was shooting in the first half,
held them 21 points in the second half. You know, it was almost as if something hexed Reading Central Catholic with about 2 minutes to go in the first half, because their passing just broke down against the pressure of Eastern. And it was very bizarre the way that happened, because they were so impressive on their passing game and so impressive as shooters.
Reisinger sinks both, 67-51. Duren with it, he'll put it up from long range. It's short. Rebound, Hennies loses it. Out of bounds, 22 seconds left. Reading Central Catholic will get the basketball. Pete Kress coming in, replacing Gene Duren. Duren leaving the game with 12 points. Reading Central Catholic season will end here tonight. Eastern will go on. 2 points for Steve Klein. We wind down, final 10 seconds of the ball game. 5 seconds, four, three. Here's a layup chance for Roland. No good. Rebound knob, no good. And that ends the ball game. Eastern goes on to the semifinals of District 3, and they have a berth in the state tournament playoffs. 69-51, your final. We'll be back with a recap of this ball game in just a moment.
Starting, let's do the field goal percentages. 50% for the Golden Knights, 26 of 52 for the Reading Central Catholic Cards, 22 of 45, 49%. But the key stat is in the second half, they shot 9 of 28, 32%. So they went from 76% shooting in the first half, 32% in the second half, 49% overall. So that's a deceptive 49%. At the foul line, Eastern was 17 of 26, many of those coming late as the Cards tried to get back in the game. Cardinals 7 of 11. Turnovers, 10 even, but I think the significant thing here for Mark Eckert is that on Tuesday night, Eastern had 19 turnovers, so they cut those by 9. Coaches love to see that category go down. Key factor in the game, the rebounds. For the Eastern Golden Knights, they had 37 rebounds to 17 for Reading Central Catholic, 25 rebounds in the second half to 11 rebounds in the second half for the Cards. Eastern scored 13 points off 17 offensive rebounds tonight.
And John Robb proved to be the factor in that department.
He did indeed.
Individually, John Robb, for the 17th time this year, has led Eastern in scoring. He had 18. Kirk Riekert with 17 points. And Bobby Alba with 12 points. And Alba with 12 points, a couple of big passes there, the big steals. That's why he is our prison player.
I tell you, I think kids are lucky to be alive in the 1980s, because we have videotape and we have high school games on TV. Because if I was Bobby Alba, I'd want to get this one on tape and show it to my kids, because you don't throw many passes like you did at the end of that first half on the numbers to Rob on the run. Slam dunk.
Big one right there that tied the game at 30 at the end of the first half. Reading Central Catholic, Gene Duren with 12, Bob Skaborek with 12, and John Reedy with just 9, three of them in the second half, when he was in foul trouble with 4 fouls. He eventually fouled out of the game.
It really took him out of the game. They knew he was the leading scorer coming in. As I said, both teams are young, but on this given night, Eastern's youth proved to be more experienced, proved to be more telling in the long run.
Eastern on to the semifinals of District 3 Class AA, and they have a ticket into the state playoffs. Reading Central Catholic goes back home and will think about what they have to do to get back here next season. Our next game, possibly York Catholic in the District 3 AAA semifinals. Check your local papers for time and coverage of District 3 Basketball 87 on Cable 4 York. District 3 Basketball 87 on Cable 4 York is brought to you by Sherrison Lehman Brothers. Sherrison Lehman Brothers and the Serious Investor. Minds over money. 110 East Market Street in York. Call 854-5553. So for Craig Smith and statistician Paul Kudemote, I'm Ken Schott. Thank you for joining us once again on Cable 4 York. Our final score, the Eastern Golden Knights going on to this
District 3 semifinals of Class AA with a 69-51 victory over Reading Central Catholic. I'm Ken Schott. Good night, everybody.